JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for August the 6th. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded quietly against the other major currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It traded within a plus minus 0.15% range against all those currencies, but one. The exception was the British pound, which was found higher against the US dollar by 0.21%. What resulted in a slight strengthening in the British currency may have been the outcome of the Bank of England monetary policy gathering. The bank kept all its policy settings unchanged, with policymakers voting unanimously in favor of keeping interest rates untouched, but with one member dissenting on the quantitative easing voting. Expectations were for two members to dissent, and thus, at first glance, only one official supporting tapering seems somewhat dovish. However, the highlight was not the voting. In our view, it was the bank's statement that they will start reducing their stock of bonds when the policy rate hits 0.50% by not reinvesting the proceeds of maturing debt, as long as that makes sense for the economy. The previous guidance was for the bank to not start unwinding its bond purchases until interest rates were near 1.5%. So, some participants may have interpreted this as a way of saying that quantitative easing tapering may start earlier than previously anticipated, and that's why they bought some pounds. However, it could also be translated as interest rates staying lower for longer. That's why the pound did not gain much, in our view. So in any case, markets are pricing a first rate increase to 0.25% in the Bank of England benchmark rate around August next year, with the 0.5% threshold expected to be hit in late 2023 or early 2024. Now, as for today, the spotlight is likely to fall on the US employment report for July. Non-farm payrolls are expected to have accelerated to 870K from 850K, while the unemployment rate is anticipated to have declined to 5.7% from 5.9%. That said, on Wednesday, the ADP report revealed that the private sector has gained less than expected jobs, actually less than half the forecasted number, which tilts the risks surrounding the NFP number to the downside. Average hourly earnings are forecast to have grown 0.3% month over month, the same pace as in June, but this will take the year-over-year rate up to 3.8% from 3.6%. At last week's gathering, the FOMC kept its policy unchanged, but although officials repeated that they will keep the pace of their quantitative easing purchases unchanged until substantial further progress has been made towards their goals, they added that the economy has made such progress and that they will continue to assess the progress in coming meetings. Having said that, though, at the press conference following the decision, Fed Chair Powell said that the labor market has still a long way to go, and that inflation is still expected to fall back to their longer-run goals. He also added that the timing of Tapering will depend on incoming data, and that they will provide advance notice before any changes, something that may have put cold water on expectations of an early tightening. However, after that, several other policymakers, and most recently Fed Vice Chair Richard Clarida, appeared more hawkish than Powell, arguing that interest rates may even start rising in 2022. Remember, the latest dot plot suggests that that interest rates may start rising in 2023. In any case, a downside surprise will be more in line with Powell's remarks and may result in some USD selling. At the same time, equities are likely to gain more on expectations that with quantitative easing tapering not in sight soon, borrowing costs will stay cheap for longer. On the other hand, a strong report could undermine Powell's view and may revive speculation over early tapering and thereby earlier rate hikes. The US dollar could gain in that case, while equities could correct lower, even if a strong report means that the economic recovery remains robust. At the same time, with the US employment report, we get jobs data for July from Canada as well. The unemployment rate is forecast to have declined to 7.4% from 7.8%, while the employment change is expected to reveal a slowdown to 177.5K from 230.7K. That said, 177.5K jobs growth still appears decent to us. At its prior gathering, the Bank of Canada appeared less hawkish than expected, saying that they continue to see the output gap closing in the second half of 2022, which suggests that their expectations over when they may start raising interest rates have not come forth. What's more, last week, both headline and core Canadian inflation rates declined, which may have added credence to that view. However, a strong employment report may raise some speculation over some earlier action by the Bank of Canada and perhaps support the Canadian dollar. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day and greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.